America was gripped by the devastating testimony of more than 150 gymnasts who came forward to accuse their medical doctor of abuse. Now it's volleyball, and these women say they were abused by their coach when they were only 16. Megan Alexander has their story.
Oh, great up, Lindsay!
She's a top volleyball coach, teaching these young girls all the skills to make it to the top. On the court, she watches their every move.
Let's go!
But off the court, she wants to protect them from an evil she says she experienced. Sarah Powers-Barnhard was just 16 when she says her volleyball coach started sexually abusing her.
He stood up, took my hand, and took me into the back room, undressed me, and that was the first time I'd ever had sex. And it was uncomfortable, it hurt.
Once a rising star on the volleyball court in the Chicago area, Sarah says the abuse lasted for 2 years.
Hey, good serves!
Now 53, she says her coach, Rick Butler, groomed her by isolating her from the rest of the team.
He said, you need to understand to be great, you have to follow me blindly. You're not like everybody else. You need to work harder. You need to listen to my instructions. You need to believe or you're not going to reach your goals. And so I, of course, said yes.
Christine Tuzzi also played top-level volleyball for Coach Butler. She is brought to tears as she relives the memories of what she says he did to her.
He backed me up against the sink. He had kissed me and then put his hands down my pants.
Christine says Butler wrote her several dozen letters, including this one.
I guess it comes down to the fact that I love you very much and I'm scared to death of losing you. We have the most special relationship that I ever have known and I feel like it's coming to an end. A lot of people refer to these as love letters and that's very hard for me. These are anything but love. They're abuse letters, they're not love.
Butler has been banned for life from USA Volleyball, but he still coaches and runs a massive facility, Sports Performance Volleyball Club in Aurora, Illinois.
Mr. Butler, do you have a moment? I'd like to talk to you about the multiple women that have accused you of sexual assault. We spoke to two women, sir, who called you a sexual predator. Do you have anything to say to them?
Butler claims he never sexually abused any individual, but has admitted to having sex with three of his former players, including Christine and Sarah, saying they were all consensual relationships that began after the women turned 18.
When the victims were playing for Rick Butler, they saw him as a god. They saw him as the most powerful male figure in their lives. The fact that they later would have to take him on was incredibly daunting to them.
Like the victims of Dr. Larry Nassar, these former volleyball players are now speaking out.
We can't have this in our sports arenas anymore. And the only way to do it is victims like us speaking up, the swimmers, the skaters, the gymnasts. We're all sisters in it.
Nice serve, nice serve.
Those two women are part of a federal class action lawsuit which seeks to prevent Rick Butler from coaching minors. Butler has never been criminally charged.